Father, we thank you for the gift of life that you have given to us. We bless your holy name. We said, hallelujah be unto your name. This morning, this is Grace of Life Gospel Ministry International, the house of champions, where everybody becomes somebody, where the impossible becomes possible. We are here, Lord, to listen to your word. Visit your people as you have said. Those who are on the YouTube, those who are listening to us on the Facebook Live, visit them wherever they are in the whole world. Let your word transform and change your people for better. We come against every hindrances, every power of darkness that always holding the blessings of the people of God, always blocking the blessings of the people of God. We silence them in the name of Jesus. Hold those stick under the control. Let it will be done. And at the end of the day, God, honor will be given unto you. We bless you, Father, for answering prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, shout a big amen.
Say amen.
You can sit down.
Wait to me at Nasi.
As a king and a queen.
Ohini, ene, ohima.
Today we are going to pay allegiance to Almighty God.
Yeah, they need you, ma, as a for ready, ene.
Look at your neighbor sitting by you. Tell the person, Jesus is your answer.
Yesu, ene umuai.
Tell the person again, Jesus is your answer.
Catch and say, yes, any umuai.
Whatever you are,
baby, I will be.
Jesus is your answer.
Yes, any umuai.
Amen.
Amen.
Open your Bible to Luke. Luke chapter number 5.
You try to call Luke. It's in
verse 1 up to 9.
It's back on Ecosy.
Luke chapter 5.
Luke, it's in
verse 1 up to 9.
You move back on Ecosy and Crown.
And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gerizat and saw two sheep standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the church. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your net for a draught. And Simon answered, said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing, let down the net. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net broke, and they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O God. For he was astonished, and all that were with him, at the draught of the fishes which they had taken. Amen.
Amen.
The topic of my message.
780.
Launch out into the deep.
She egu aye insunum.
Launch out into the deep.
Fagu bia edohonum.
Amen.
Amen.
Launch into the deep.
Tu eko bebia edoho.
The message God said, I should announce to somebody listening to me.
Asem a oni Yesu se men kan chine obi ne.
Somebody who has struggled for years.
Obi a wa prepare enfi bebiri.
That he cannot show anything. I'm talking about the people who have been struggling in life for years.
I'm
talking to people who have been desperate in life, that they don't know what to do. That's one thing secret in life. Anything that you cannot do for yourself, give it to Christ to do it.
Amen. Amen.
If you want the multitude of blessings, it is not from any man, but it is from Jesus. Bible said, Peter gave the boat to Jesus.
Peter or the boat to Jesus.
In life, anything that you gave to Jesus first, to accomplish the gospel, then at the end of the day, then the blessings that you were looking for will give it unto you exceedingly, abundantly, above what we are thinking for. If you are a child of God, you are the temple God is looking for. God wants to use somebody for his purpose. We are Christians. We have one commission. He said, go eat into the whole world. Preach the gospel. That is the one of the vital way every child of God must do. But now the evangelism was not going on again. Why? Because we thought we have fed up in the Christendom. But Jesus wants one thing from each and everyone. He needs your boat. He needs your life. He needs your gifts to exercise in his kingdom. Don't think about anything, because it takes years for a man to enter into problems. But breakthrough is just one day. You have struggled a lot. If you can allow Jesus Christ to take absolute control over your life, to take control over everything you have, if you can give your life to Christ, if you can give your boat to Christ for him to use it, then after he uses it, then he will restore back unto you. I pray for somebody here. Let God use you. Anything that you have, give unto Christ for him to use it. After using it, then he will pave a way for you. May the blessings of God, may the favors of God come upon you. Anything that you have, either it is money, either it is your gift, allow God to use it first. And after using it, then he will make the impossible become possible. In the name of
Jesus,
shout a big amen.
He
said, we have toiled the whole night. With God, all things are possible. There's a secret in the kingdom prosperity. And what you need to do is to allow Jesus to take control. Don't let your will be done. Let Jesus use you for his own purposes. And after he used you for his purposes, then your expectation will be granted. I pray for somebody that you will never give up. Peter said, have tried the whole night. By your word. By your word. It is better to trust only God. No matter the circumstances that you find yourself, you have to believe only the word of God. Bible said, Who has believed the report of God? It is only the word of God that can change destiny. Devil can plant a lot. The wicked people can plant a lot. But it is only the counsel of God that shall stand. Whatever you are, listen to me. If you can put your trust in the word of God and believe that God is not a man that he should lie, no matter how many years you have been struggling, today God will make a way where sin there's no way. May God make a way for you, somebody. May God make a way for you, someone. In the name of
Jesus.
What you have to do, what belongs to you, the gift you have, the energy you have, the time you have, give unto God for his purpose. And stop thinking about your welfare. But after God have using you to accomplish his purposes, then what you don't expect will come to you. May God empower somebody. May you avail yourself for Jesus to use you for his kingdom to accomplish his purposes, and your expectation will be granted physically in the name of
Jesus.
Because anytime that you find gold, you will meet God. But when you thank God, God will just pursue you. I pray for you
that
allow Jesus to take control. Today you are the boat. God needs you. He needs your time. He needs your money. He needs everything about you for the kingdom first. And after you do that, your life will not be the same. Jesus said, Peter, I need your boat.
Peter, me here.
What is your boat?
Your
boat can be your money to accomplish the kingdom of God. Your boat can be your gift to promote the kingdom of God. Your boat can be your property to support the kingdom of God. And after Jesus have done all this for his kingdom, then he will come into your aid and be a blessing to you. There's no way you will invest in the kingdom of God and your life will be the same. Anything that you sow in Christ, he will make sure you reap in thousandfolds. Your suffering will not be in vain. Keep on giving to Christ. Don't give up in life.
Oh,
you have got nothing. Your prayers have not been answered yet. But still give the gift to Christ. Give your time to Christ. After he has done everything, then what is impossible will be possible for your life. I pray for you this morning, after giving your time to sit here and to listen to the word of God, may God restore back unto you. Because those who wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. May God renew your finances. May God renew your marriage. May God renew your favor. May you mount like an eagle. I pray for an overtaking anointing. The unction for you to function. Those who said they have gone ahead of you, because that you are in the presence of God, doing the kingdom of God, receive the overtaking anointing. Receive the overtaking anointing in your finances. Receive the divine connection in the name of
Jesus.
Sometimes we struggle a lot because it's not our will should be done, but let the will of God to be first.
Amen.
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 Amen. It's a launch into the deep.
It's
a master. The whole night. We got nothing.
Amen.
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 Maybe the whole year. The whole month, nothing have shown. But this morning, you are going to launch into the deep. And before your eye open, God will call somebody to be a blessing to you. You have no idea. Sometimes it's not your strength. It's not your power. It's not your business ideas. It's not how English you can speak. But if you give your life to Christ, if you give what you have to Christ, after he uses it, then there will be a miracle. I knew that people or other the fishermen, they will tell that Peter, make sure you take money from this man. He cannot use your boat and go the same. Take money. Amen.
Amen.
I knew.
Amen.
Amen. But nobody who will do something for God, that God will not restore back unto you. Maybe today you not see it, but after a while, he who have power, he who open no one can shout, he will stop back unto you. I knew some of the fishermen will say, Peter, you are a fool.
Peter, what Jimmy?
Why allow all these things? We have suffered the whole night. We are now working on our net. You are pushing your boat to somebody.
What the boat to Yama will be?
A pastor to preach with nothing.
Amen. Amen.
But Peter did not see his struggling.
Peter was who on no bread.
But he looked the kingdom of God first.
Whoever
will think about God first,
then
God will think about
you.
I pray for you this morning.
As
you are listening to the word of God, may God restore back unto you. I
said,
cut into the deep. From today, whatever you have been looking for years, that you have not seen, before you leave here to your house, God will bring that back to you. And your expectation will transfer to other people.
And we need that.
Receive a multiple blessing. Receive a multiple blessing. Amen.
Amen.
You allow yourself to be in the house of God. To worship Him. To sing for God. To
sing
for God. Because of your boat, God will restore back unto you. I am prophesying to somebody here. You have been tough with the same year. The whole year, nothing has happened. Last month, you fasted. You have did everything that you can do. You have applied every experience you have. Nothing has shown. Today, this morning, God said, launch into the deep. He said, because of your word. If you believe God and believe His word, then I prophesy to you, before you leave here to your house, any prayer request you have put before God for so many years, it shall be granted to you. It shall be granted to you. It shall be granted to you. Receive the physical manifestation. Receive the physical manifestation. In the name of
Jesus.
With Jesus, all things are.
Yes, munu bibia ayeho.
He need you first. That's why we said we should remember our Creator in the our youth exuberance. Now that you have the energy, give it to God. Give your strength to Christ, and He will restore back unto you. Nobody will work for God, and that person's life will be the same. David said,
David can say,
I have been young and I'm old. I have not seen anyone who have done something to God, and that person's life will be the same.
I have
been young and I'll be old. I have not seen. This means anything that you can do for God, do it from your heart. And God who opened doors, the creator of the universe, the one who hold money, those, the one who created the devil, those who created the enemies to destroy, he will just lift up his hand and he said, no weapon forming against you shall prosper, because everybody have his master, and that master is God that we are serving. From today going, no weapon of the devil will form against you shall prosper. Every closing door, I open it in Jesus' name. Receive the blessings of God, because Jesus will not give the empty boat to you.
Yes, one fa bonto no kwa.
It means your suffering will not be in vain. Maybe today you will not see it. But after a day, after 2 days, when the work of God has been done, your pains will turn into gain. Your story will turn into glory. And Bible said, he told Peter,
launch
into the deep. God will not give his blessing to anybody, but he shall give to those who have allowed him to use for a purpose. And you are the one I'm talking to. Launch forth. Launch deep. Today, whoever have not count money before, you are going to count money in every currency. You don't believe it yet, because with God, all things are, all things mean good, bad and ugly. Sometimes what you don't expect is what God can do. That making God, the moment you understand God, he will not be God again. That's why if God wants to bless somebody, he will not go and consult your enemies. He will make sure those who are seeking him first, those who allow him to work through him, he will restore back unto you. None of you here will that be mature. None of you will that be mature. Any accident in this year, premature death in this year, you and your family is exempted, because you are in the presence of the Lord. You have allowed Jesus to use you to accomplish his purposes. As I'm bringing my message to an end, anything that you can do for God, do it from your heart. If you can sing for God, if you can read for God, if it is your money, give your money to God, and he will restore back unto you. May God open a new chapter for you. Peter was so surprised for the sheep he restored. May God restore back unto you your wasting time, you're wasting years,
you're
wasting months. Today, may God restore back unto you. May God restore back unto you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shout a big amen.
I say amen.